Thank you. We've always wondered what could happen if our crazy rabbits were unleashed upon the world of Mario. Today, the dream is reality. And to talk about this unexpected encounter, it is my great honor to welcome a very special guest, someone I truly admire. Please. Ladies and gentlemen, Miyamoto-san. Thank you for coming.
Thank you,
Simon. We are so happy to have you today. So what have you brought with you?
Well,
what did you bring?
This is a life-size replica of one of the weapons from this game.
Wow. Cool. I'm sure you love it.
I brought one for you.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Wow. Woo. So... So let's take a picture.
Bill-san, he can help our conversation. これほら、ね、Ghost Recon とちょっと違うでしょ?
These are a little bit different from the weapons you see in Ghost Recon.
かわいいでしょ?
Yeah, very different weapons for very different worlds. this one is, I think, very effective in the world of Mario and Rabbit. So, should do well. I'm so proud of Ubisoft's long-standing collaboration with Nintendo. You know, from the DS to the Wii, and more recently for the impressive launch of the Switch, you know, it has always been, we have always been inspired by Nintendo and by all the great work you have been able to do.
そうですね。本当にいつも UBI さんにはね、協力いただいてありがとうございます。
Yes, thank you very much for all the work that we've been able to do together over the years with Ubisoft.
もうほら、出会ってから25年ぐらい経つんですよね。
I mean, Yves, it's already been about 25 years since you and I first met.
で、E3 とかに来るたんびに UBI さんのブースを僕は訪問して、で、ビデオで撮ってもらって、社内のビデオに登場したりしてましたね。
And every year at E3, you're kind enough to invite me to your booth, and we get to take lots of pictures and videos, and I've even recorded messages for Ubisoft employees in the past.
そのたんびにね、なんか UBI の開発の皆さんのすごい任天堂ゲーム愛みたいなものを感じてきました。
So over the years, I've always felt the deep, heartfelt passion that Ubisoft developers have for Nintendo and its characters.
それは一方でね、僕は同じ開発者としてライバルですから、こう戦う姿勢で頑張ってきたんですけど。
But on the other hand, because we're both software developers, we've also looked at each other as kind of rivals and tried to see who could make the best software.
けどまあイブさんからラビッツの人形をもらったりいろいろして、僕の席の前にもラビッツがいっぱいあるんですけども。そういうラビッツのヒューモアはすごく理解してました。
But of course, I've known the Rabbids characters for many years, and I have many Rabbids figures decorating my desk. Wow. And so I've always been a fan of the characters and their humor.
だから今回の話があった時にダビッツがどんなユーモアをこうゲームの中で見せてくれるかすごい楽しみにしてたんですね。
So since this project first started, I've been very excited to see what kind of humor the rabbits could bring to the Mario world.
で、ただ、ダビッツさんに会った時にね、ダビッツさんに一つだけお願いしたんです。
So when I met Davide-san, who is the creative director of this game. Yes. When I met Davide-san, I had just one condition for this project.
絶対こうジャンプするゲームとかそういうプラットフォームゲームじゃなくて、マリオで今まで作ったことのないジャンルのゲームを作ってほしいとお願いしました。
I said, whatever you do, don't try to make a jump game or a Mario platformer. Try to make a Mario game that has never been made before.
よかったですね。
and it's great.
And I can tell you, it was an exciting, very exciting challenge for all our teams. And I think we have done something you will love. So, thank you very much for giving us the chance to perform on this game.
はい、本当にこうヨーロッパで作るとこんなものができるのかとかね、それから、UBI さんやっぱりアクションゲームをちゃんと作ってる会社なんで、こうストラテジー単性のストラテジーゲームというもののちゃんとこうテンポのいいゲームが出来上がりました。
And so, of course, because the game is being made in Europe, it has a very unique flavor to it. And of course, Ubisoft is very good at making action games, but this game in particular has a great layer of strategy and tactics to it, but with a very good pace.
Yeah, no, it's going to be fresh, actually. So now let's welcome Xavier, you know, the producer of the game, and he will show us the game. So thanks again. Thanks again, Miyamoto.
Finally, we can talk about this project. So we've been working on this game for more than 3 years now, and to be at E3 today, on this stage, is just super exciting. So, what is this game exactly? So Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle is a tactical adventure exclusive for the Nintendo Switch, and let's check right away some gameplay. So the Rabbids have been teleported into the Mushroom Kingdom, and it made the world completely unstable and chaotic. So Mario, as a true hero, wants to save the day. But this time, with some new friends. And at first, they don't really know each other, but in the end, they will form this dream team that will potentially save the Mushroom Kingdom. And as the game is a turn-based tactical adventure game, combat is a really big part of the concept. So you'll fight wave after wave of rabbits that somehow turn bad. And what we see here is just the very beginning of the game, so it'll be perfect to talk about the combat basics. So the two flags you see on the screen here is to tell you this is a battlefield zone. So you'll switch from exploration mode to battle mode. The blue zone is your zone of movement, so you move anywhere you want in that zone. But you can also use battlefield ingredients, such as covers, for protection. So Rabbit Luigi here using half cover or full cover. And we also have what we call team jump. So by jumping on your teammate, you can expand your zone of movement. So here, Rabbit Peach, using Mario, she's able to flank the enemy. So you can also attack the enemy behind that cover and expose them by destroying that cover, which is really interesting in terms of strategy because for next turns, you'll be open for attacks. And last but not least, techniques. So from defensive ones, like Rabbit Peach Shield Boost, or offensive ones, like Mario's Hero Sight, he's able to attack the enemy even if it's not his turn, as soon as the enemy moves. So this is a very core aspect of the game itself. So you mix and match attack options, movement abilities, techniques, but we also have other ingredients such as pipes, rabbit pipes. So those give you a good move to flank the enemy. So here, for example, Rabbit Luigi goes into the pipe, out of the pipe, dash the enemy, goes for Mario, team jump, land behind the enemy in one single movement sequence, and then finish off the enemy. And what we see here is actually explosive cover. So those have many type of super effects, and this one was a push effect. So you can push heroes or enemies out of the boundaries. So again, this is just a glimpse into the basics of the game. And as you progress into the game, you have more tactic tools. You'll be able to do more combo setups. You'll be able to use different type of heroes, different type of weapons, in order to battle your way through the kingdom. Thank you. And that's just a glimpse into the game itself. But first and foremost, this is a project done with passion, with our hearts. So it would not exist otherwise. So we just can't wait for you guys to try the game at E3 this week. For those who are not at E3, you'll see online coverage, videos, and surprises. So have a great conference. Have a great E3. Thank you. Woo!
Hi, I'm Ashraf Ismail, game director for Assassin's Creed Origins. I've waited a long time to say that. Almost 10 years ago, I, as many of you, fell in love with a game. That game took us to the Third Crusade. And we fell in love again when it took us to the Italian Renaissance. Over the years, this amazing series has taken us to the American Revolution, the French Revolution, Victorian London, and of course, to the Republic of Pirates. For the 10-year anniversary of Assassin's Creed, for our fans, for ourselves, and for all newcomers, we wanted to go back, very far back, to show how it all began. Since Black Flag, over the last 3.5 years, we have poured our energy, our talent, our passion into bringing the land of pyramids, pharaohs, and mummies to life, to bring ancient Egypt to life. Now, Egypt challenged us. It fundamentally challenged us to reinvent what it means to be Assassin's Creed. And over the next few days, you will see, play, and feel this reinvented experience. I am deeply honored and proud to be here representing the amazing work of a phenomenal team, and thrilled to finally be able to show you this beast we have been building. Without further ado, here is a taste of Egypt. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. As an extra treat, let's check in with home base, where we're going to get a glimpse of what you'll see right after the UB conference.
Hey there, folks. Chris Waters here at the home base with Hany Duong and Carl Lue, producer on Assassin's Creed Origins at Ubisoft Singapore. Carl's here to give us a look at the gameplay of the game. We're going to be entering the open world. We've got a ton more to show you, but Carl, kick it off. Give us a little taste here.
Yes, so here we are in the open world of Egypt. This is the demo that we will be showing on the show floor here at E3. Bayek is riding into the Fayoum, one of the regions in Egypt, the most southernmost region. It's a beautiful area. We see we've come in from the desert, moving towards this Lake Moeris. And let's have a little exploration around here using our eagle scene.
It's sunny on the lake, and it's sunny on the monitor here, but folks, this looks really good. It's running on an Xbox One X. We'll be giving you the gameplay feed after the show. We've got 30 minutes of that coming up, but let's see if we can see from a bird's eye view what Senu is up to.
Yeah, so Senu is looking into this military camp and tagging a few enemies here. After the show, we will infiltrate this camp and take it out either through stealth or combat or perhaps ranged weaponry.
All right, if you guys want to see more of this, be sure to tune in right after the conference. Chris and I and Carl here will be right here. Ash will be joining us as well. You won't want to miss it.
That 30 minutes live gameplay feed is coming up after the show, but for now, it's back to the stage and on with the excitement.
That's it for now. Thank you.
Thank you.
So don't forget that you can watch this demo in its entirety after the conference, live stream from our home base. And for those of you here at E3, please come to the Ubisoft booth where you can live this new experience of Assassin's Creed. Thank you very much.
Here's your chance.
Career dominate off-road racing on his way to the top.
Champion swings around it brilliantly. Now that's the skill that wins no matter what the engine, no matter what the track. He is this season's undisputed motorsports champion, coming out of nowhere to rise to the top.
Thank you. 2 years back, the crew took the driving genre out there to the big, wide, open world of the USA. Thanks to our players, we have taken this iconic vision to the next level. They showed us what they liked and what they wanted to see in the future. Now, it's time to take it way beyond driving. I am Stefan Bellet, Creative Director. This is The Crew 2. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Here in the US, motorsports are louder, bigger, edgier than anywhere else in the world. Drivers and fans meet across the country and celebrate a common passion for all things motorized. Now's your chance to join in. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to The Crew 2, home of Motor Nation.
People talk to me.
the heart of the city, street racers prove their skills, skidding on rooftops, burning asphalt, and tuning their ride. Off-road through the striking beauty of nature. Unpredictable waves on the open ocean, rapid waters, or narrow rivers. Fearless pilots rule the skies, spin between buildings, through the clouds, among stunning, stunning perspectives. All across the country, high-octane contests await you. Take the lead on modernation. You've had a glimpse of the Crew 2. Register now for beta access or play the demo at the booth. Experience TC2 for yourself. Enjoy the ride. Thank you.
We all wanted to be superheroes for the same reason. You're a traitor, Tweak, and now you're with a group of super traitors.
This was started by you.
We aren't the ones who walked out of the fucking franchise, Mysterion.
Why would the Freedom Pals help us?
We send a spy, someone in our group who pretends to want to switch sides and join Freedom Pals. Somebody who they don't know very well. All this fair in love and war, Freedom Pussy.
You fucking animal.
You've got problems, new kid. Whatever you did last night got a lot of people's attention. Bad people. If you need information, just know you can rely on Call Girl.
Who the fuck is that? So I guess now any fucking asshole thinks they can be a superhero.
We're gonna rip you apart.
Dude, Mysterion is pissed at you, new kid. Toolshed?
Toolshed is a catchy tier class visionary archetype.
And a butt-fucking traitor.
Oh,
you must listen to me.
Get out of my head, Timmy.
Your franchise is going nowhere. Face the truth, Eric. You guys are kind of douchebags.
He just called us douchebags, in my mind.
He did?
Southpaw, the fractured, but homed.
Available October 17th.
Was this sort of synergy of, well, we're looking to do something interesting in VR and we've got this division and you're looking to sort of bring, you know, what sense you have of storytelling within and put that into the context of VR.
You can, for the first time as a player, feel like you are in a movie.
That's a really good word for it. We want you to take off the gear and still feel unsettled.
Whilst working with Ubisoft, we stumbled across some fascinating research that had begun in the late 90s. Essentially, neuroscientists had figured out a way to upload brain data, trauma, emotions, memories, to the digital space. Now, we've gone and taken the next logical step, and with Ubisoft, we've recreated in virtual reality one such test subject. So we'd like you to come and join us and experience the Walter test case for yourself.
Not as
so
we don't want to.
Again.
What you're experiencing is a recorded consciousness. It's not like watching a movie, so no matter how real it may seem, it can't hurt you. You are completely safe. You are completely safe.
And now, I'm happy to share a new surprise with you. Building on the legacy of one of our most popular worlds, the super talented teams of Ubisoft Singapore came up with something really, really unique. So I want you to see that and enjoy. Thank you.
Men from all over the world sail the treacherous trade routes of the Indian Ocean. The riches in their holds fuel their dreams of power and fortune, while whetting the appetites of those they fear most. Pirates.
Unlock the door. No, I never go.
120 days. That's how long the average pirate survived a lawless life on the seas during the golden age of piracy. I'm Justin Farron, the creative director for Skull and Bones, and this is your chance to not just survive, but to climb the food chain and surpass the legend of every pirate who ever sailed the high seas. Since bringing innovative naval combat to Assassin's Creed, we at Ubisoft Singapore have set out to bring you the ultimate pirate experience. A tactical action game where we take that naval combat to the next level, mastering the ocean and its winds at the helm of ships armed to the teeth. Skull and Bones takes place in a shared systemic world where you can sail solo or form a gang of pirates with your friends and together terrorize the trade routes of the Indian Ocean. Season after season, you'll collaborate and compete with other bloodthirsty players, even execute ruthless betrayals, in order to become the ultimate pirate kingpin. Now I'm proud to share with you the Loot Hunt, one of Skull and Bones' 5v5 team-based PvP modes. Right on, right? We've just received intel that merchant convoys rich with treasure are sailing just off the coast of Madagascar. But beware, there are other pirates also looking to plunder the PvP disputed waters of the Indian Ocean.
The Procellus Shallows of Madagascar, located on the cusp of a bustling trade route, it is the perfect place for an ambush. Here is our gang of pirates, the Raiders, going head-to-head with a gang of rival players, the Cutthroats. Victory goes to the team with the most loot at the end of the hunt.
Are we ready for a hunt?
Knowing how to sail with the wind is a pirate's most precious skill. Use the winds to increase your speed or to position yourself for tactical advantage in battle. To reap the most rewards, it is best to split up, some going inland, others keeping to the open sea. Each warship has unique strengths. The frigate's hull is reinforced, its arsenal equipped with numerous culverin cannons. The brigantine is devastating up close, with a battering ram designed to break any resistance. The sloop of war kills from afar with its crippling long-ranged mortars and precise long nine cannons.
Sail! Flying hostile colors! All sail! Ride the wind!
All hands on deck!
Position fixed!
Open fire! Nothing will save you now! You soggy nutmegs!
Don't let bloodlust cloud your purpose. You're here for the loot, and so are your rivals.
Store the goods, then back to your station!
The team that escapes with the most loot claims victory. Searching for more targets on the horizon, our sloop of war spots a rival pirate ship further inland. With its heavily reinforced hull, our frigate swoops in to save the day, bearing the brunt of the damage. Now taking aim at the frigate, and it will take team coordination to take her down.
Fuego!
Hold tight, man! That ship's badly damaged!
they're killing, we can take their ship.
With the enemy ship's broadside now vulnerable, our frigate rushes in to board her.
No quarter! Taste the blackened silver.
Fancy snorting some fish piss?
Pirate hunters have been sent in, signaling the end of the hunt. They target the pirates with the most stolen loot.
Time to make our escape, Captain, or we are good for the news.
They're firing mortars!
Full tilt, Silbo, full tilt!
The pirate hunter defenses are so strong that the only option is escape. The brigantine is sacrificing herself to buy time for the frigate who carries the most loot. The frigate now needs to make its escape through the reefs.
Captain, that's back for the reefs!
Successful pirates know when to run, with their hulls full and the wind at their backs. Yeah!
Thank you all very much. I'd like to invite you to play the loot hunt at the Ubisoft booth at E3. And please register for our live phases online. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention, the world of Skull and Bones is one that evolves. When you act, it reacts.
That if I did not kiss the girls, my lips would grow a moldy. We'll haul away,
pop. But I just wanna dance with somebody. 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 It could be anybody. Tell me, are you that somebody? Don't matter who you are, just love me the way I am. I just wanna dance with somebody. I just wanna dance with somebody. Ooh,
somebody. Hey! Hey everyone, I'm Bebe Rexha, and Just Dance 2018 is out this October on all consoles. Bye!
You use it as a telephone. You use it as a camera. It's your music player, your flashlight, calculator, and GPS navigation device. But now, finally, the most high-tech company in the world has unlocked the mobile phone's true potential so that it can do what it was truly meant to do.
We are playing Cowboys and Indians. Hey, new kid, we need you to come play with us. Put on some cowboy shit and meet us outside. And bring your phone. Whoa, whoa, we're playing Cowboys and Indians, dickhole. Inuits are technically Native Americans. This new kid puts me to shame. Rip these guys a new asshole, new kid.
Phone Destroyer!
Atlas, jewel of the Pleiades. Nova took us to the stars. Each new world more incredible than the last. We had no idea what was waiting for us. The Legion. It consumes everything in its path. They've never used Starlink before. Go show them what it can do.
Okay, let's do this. Come on, come on. I got it.
Chase, how's it going?
Breaking atmosphere.
Time for me to jumpstart the engine.
They are resisting ice barrage, linking fire loadout.
We're up against impossible odds, but together we will adapt and overcome.
I'm Matt Rose, producer at Ubisoft Toronto. Like many of you, I grew up in the 80s, obsessed with sci-fi, animation, comics, and of course, all the really cool toys. At Ubisoft Toronto, we built a team with a dream of bringing those amazing childhood memories back back to life for a new generation. Starlink, Battle for Atlas, allows you to take control of a team of star pilots in a massive, open, living star system, fighting to save Atlas from the Forgotten Legion. Build your custom starship, and then adapt to new challenges on the fly. Link extra armor and heavy weapons to take on a huge Legion Prime. Search for ancient secrets lost on the worlds of Atlas, or outrun outlaws through an asteroid field. Freedom is at the core of Starlink Battle for Atlas. Collect your way with both physical starship collectibles and digital versions available, and even take your game on the go using the power of Nintendo Switch. Visit starlinkgame.com for more information, and stay tuned for many more surprises over the coming months. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Coutaz. I'm the studio director at Ubisoft Annecy. It's a pleasure for me to be back on stage after our announcement at E3 last year. And we have had since then a full year of support and continuous development of Steep. Since the very beginning of this project, we have been working with athletes and we have always been impressed by their passion and dedication. We learned how one champion spent 300 days a year on a trampoline to practice for that perfect landing. We learned how others make more than 6 million turns to practice for the 15 they have to race in competition. These athletes, they travel to the world to train with the best, to compete with the strongest, and to challenge themselves with the most experienced and skilled coaches. It's truly a level of passion and dedication that goes well beyond our everyday lives. And when you talk to the very best of these men and women, you realize that there is something they always have in back of their minds at all times. It's a dream that takes years of preparation for just one go at that unforgettable moment. This December, with our first Steep expansion, this is the journey you will take. Enjoy.
You would wait and watch from far away, but you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you'd lay awake and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream. We'll be right back.
Hi, my name is Dan Hay, and I'm the executive producer of Far Cry the Brand, as well as the creative director of Far Cry 5. I'd like to introduce you to Hope County, Montana. Vast, beautiful, rugged. A place where people don't even lock their front door anymore. But that's how it used to be. Today, Hope County's been overrun by a fanatical cult. You find yourself trapped deep in cult territory, cut off from the rest of the world. They've closed the roads. There's no cell phone signal, no 911. People are fucking scared. I had to say it. And just up ahead, the small town of Falls End has been completely overrun. If you're gonna survive, you and your guns for hire are gonna need to save it. But to do that, well, you're gonna need to raise some hell.
We got piggies.
Town looks like a war zone. Where do you want me? Water tower, got it.
Me out. Oh, yeah. Off my feet.
Looks like you could use some help.
Boom, 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 boom.
Target bang, a bang, fucking bang, quad. Bang.
Boom, 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 boom.
Where is your master? I don't deal with domesticated.
Hey, the fuck? I ain't got no master, but I do have your little toy.
Show me the idol. Show me the redeemer.
Here you go, mate.
Oh, Gotcha.
Yo, 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 hand it over. I got a hot date who don't do late.
Monkey's got a date. Mwah. What? What?
What, what? That's Swiss fucking chocolate, pig.
Bon appetito.
I want every fucking cop in this fucking city after that fucking bastard!
Grab my chassis, Noxie!
Easy peasy, bro!
Shit!
Fuck me.
It's about bloody time. Let's see what we've got. Moksha. Just as Yama described it. True freedom lies beyond.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. First of all, I want to say a big thank you to all the teams who worked very, very, very hard on creating all this world. Again, thank you to all these teams behind us. I want also to say thank you to Eve, with all my heart. Thanks, Eve, for making this happen. This is just amazing. And also a special thanks to the fans of Beyond Good and Evil for sticking with us for so long.
It's about bloody time.
15 years, almost.
So welcome to System 3. Our story takes place before the birth of Jade, in a multi-ethnic, multicultural human society in a distant solar system. It is a time when corporations create hybrids in their labs and enslave them to colonize the stars in order to compete for power and cosmic resources. With our crew of crazy and unforgettable characters, We fight in the name of freedom and the right to determine our own fate among the stars. And we will helm massive star-faring vessels through territories as spectacular as they are dangerous.
We've been working very hard just on the technology during 3 years. And today, we have a seamless online playground where we can travel across space at the speed of light. We can explore mysterious cities and discover unknown lands by ourselves or with friends. And we want you to participate in the making of this great adventure. Join our Space Monkey program. Today, and help us make beyond good and evil a world that will challenge us and bring us together for thousand adventures, thrills, and fun. And please, Eve, just join us. This is. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, congratulations, you guys. You know, Gabriel and Michel, you've done a fantastic job. It's amazing what you have been able to achieve. And you and I, and all the teams, have the power of creating games that will amaze all the gamers. And I think video games can help us to grow and to get better. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I would like to thank everyone here in the room and those who are watching us from home. Thank you for listening today and thank you for playing our games. So to all the teams at Ubisoft, thank you for your incredible imagination and enthusiasm. All of us here, we wish you all a lot of fun playing games this year. So thank you very much and have a great E3.
The biggest video game event of the year is here, and IGN has it all.
Hit it!
World premiere trailers, and breaking news as it happens.
The floor is actually shaking.
Every game, every event. IGN at E3, June 10th through 15th.